Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, grade 5. Hope you are all fine. Today we are going to start our lesson number 2, Cell to Systems, and it is our 10th lecture. So let's start our topic, Cell to Systems. So in the previous chapter, we have studied that cells are the building blocks of living organisms, and cells also are the smallest units of living organisms. So when cells combine together to form one kind of job, to perform one kind of function, they will form tissues. So when cells combine, muscle cells combine together, they form muscle tissues. So these are the similar cells or muscles, they will combine to form muscle tissues. So this is the example of a muscle tissue. This is the example of muscle tissue. So when epidermal cells combine together, they form epidermis of plant. Epidermis is the outer covering of the plant that protects it. This is the thinner covering this is, and if we have a closer view, this is the epidermis of a plant. So let's study about tissues. So what are tissues? When cells which perform similar function and they have similar shape, they will group together to form tissues. When similar cells, अब cells के जिनकी same shape हो और जो एक तरह के function perform कर रहे हो, like muscle cells, they perform the same function of movement. They will combine together to form muscle tissues. So these cells having same shape and function group together to form tissues. So there are different types of tissues in plants and animals. In today's lecture, we will study about the animal tissues. So there are 4 main kinds of animal tissues. First is muscle tissues, nerve tissues, epithelial tissues, and connective tissues. So let's study about muscle tissues. So when muscle cells combine together, they form muscle tissues. So what the muscle tissues do? They help to move our body parts. These muscle tissues are attached to our bones, and they help them to move our body parts. Like we have, if we want to raise our hand, if we want to walk, so all these muscle tissues help us to move. So second is nerve tissues, where the name indicates that the nerve belongs to nervous system related to our brain. So these nerve tissues, when nerve cells combine together, they form nerve tissues. So they carry messages from one part of the body to the other, and they also carry messages to the brain. So these are the tissues that carry messages from one part of the body to the other part of the body. So the third kind of tissues are epithelial tissues. So epithelial, as the name indicates, that they form the lining of lining and form skin of our body. They form skin, the lining of mouth and stomach. The stomach has inner lining, aapne wall hoti hai stomach ke andar, that forms the lining of stomach, and mouth ke andar ki lining bhi ye banate hain. So they form skin cells banate hain ye hamare, like if you see your skin of your hand, your body there. So these are epithelial tissues that make our skin and lining of mouth and stomach. So the fourth kind of tissues are connective tissues. As the name indicates, that they connect two parts. They connect two body parts. So the connective tissues combine together or join together and support various parts of our body. For example, they will support bones and blood. So they will, connective tissues combine together to support bones. They will provide it strength, and it also can perform the function of blood. So this is our today's topic. Now I will write your homework on the board. So this is your homework. Define tissues, write the definition of tissues with example, and question number 2, describe the main kinds of animal tissues. As we have discussed the 4 kinds of animal tissues, so write this question on your notebook and learn it and by heart. So to hope you understand today's lecture. If you have any queries, then you can ask me, and if you are not understanding the lecture, then you can also tell me, that I may change the lecture delivering method. So take care and Allah Hafiz.